Two children, welcome back. My name is Ella and I will be your teacher today. The last lesson we had together was about counting big numbers. So we started with a small, a medium and a large collection, and we got to over 100 in our collection by counting by twos, fives or tens. Okay. There's lots to learn about large numbers and that was a great start. Today's lesson, we're going to have a look at number lines. You might have used them before. So to help us make a number line, which will tell us if numbers are bigger or smaller than each other, we're going to need some digits. We're going to have to write some numbers down to use them and make our numbers. So today we're going to need paper and pencils and a collection of 10 things that I can write on. Now, we could write on rocks, or we could just use paper and tear the numbers. So let me show you both. Just press pause so you can grab 10 things to write on, or some piece of paper and a pencil. Okay, welcome back. Now, the digits we're going to use today are 0 to 9. Okay, so I'm going to write on my rocks, first of all, 0. And I'm going to have to put them somewhere. I'm going to use this basket, but you could use anything you have, a bowl, a cup, a basket. I'm going to write my digit 1, 2, and so on. Number 8 and number 9. We want 0 to 9. Now remember, if you don't have rocks, that's okay. Plastic tags, things to write on, that's okay. We've always got paper. Sometimes you can find some sticky notes as well. These are very handy. But let's suggest we've only got paper. That's all right. We can write 0 and tear our paper, 1 and tear our paper, and so on. Digits 0 to 9. That's what we'll need. Press pause and get ready. Right, welcome back. How did you go? Are we all set? You should have the digits 0 to 9. I've got mine on rocks, but you might have yours on paper or something else in a bowl or a cup so I can pull out these numbers to help me with my number line. Now, I need to start my number line, and my number line will start with the digit 0. So I'm going to write the number 0 and pop it at the start of my number line. The end of my number line today will be 100. So we're going to be looking at numbers from 0 to 100. And this is where 100 sits at the end of the number line I'm making today, 0 to 100. Okay. I need a piece of paper so I can write my two-digit numbers that are coming out of my basket. So we're working today in two digits, tens and ones. Okay, we're ready to go. Let's pull the first two numbers out of the basket. I'm going to pull out a 5, 5 tens. It's my first, and I've pulled out a 2. A 5 and a 2. 5 tens, 2 ones, 52. Let's write it down. 5 tens, 2 ones make 52. I'm going to tear my piece of paper now so I can place 52 on my number line. This is a great number to pick first because I know halfway between these numbers must be 50. Okay, so I'm going to place 52 near the middle. Don't forget, we need to put our numbers back. All right, let's do the next two-digit number. The next number I have pulled out is a 3. And a 6. So that gives me 3 tens and 6 ones. Okay, 3 tens and 6 ones is 36. Pop your numbers back. Write your number down and tear it off. 36. I need to put 36 on my number line now. So I need to think about what I know about perhaps my groups of 10 and where that might fit. Is 36 more than or less than 52? 3 lots of 10, 5 lots of 10. I'm going to put it down here in between my 0 and my 50. So now I have my number line from 0 to 100 and I have my first two-digit numbers. And I can now know that my 50 is in the middle and that my 30 is less than. Let's try another number. I have pulled out an 8 and 8 tens and a 1. So now I have 8 tens and 1 ones. 8, 10, and 1 ones make 81. So let's write that down and tear our piece of paper. 81. And see where this fits. 81. 8 tens. I have 3 lots of tens, 5 lots of tens. I'm thinking I'll need to put my 8 lots of tens somewhere here. The more numbers I add, the trickier it gets. So I'm going to add some more now. Please press pause and set up your number line. Welcome back. I wonder how your number line went. Here's mine. I added 10 numbers to my number line and I had to really think about which ones were smaller and larger than each other. Sometimes I had to move things around, but I did keep my 50, 52, pretty close to the middle. That helped me add my bigger numbers and my smaller numbers to my number line. Okay, so the numbers I had were 12, 18, 36, 40, and 43. All of those numbers were less than 50. The numbers I found that were more than 50 were 52, 57, 81, 83, and 96. So now I have a number line from smallest to largest. That's my first number line. I wonder if you and I had the same numbers. So now we're going to make our second number line. But this one I want to show you something a little bit different. When I pull out my two numbers, 1 and 7, I can make two different numbers with these. I can make 1 is a 10 and 7 is a 1, or I can make 7 as a 10 and 1 is a 1. I can make two different numbers with these rocks. So I am going to make a 1 and a 7, 1 10 and 1 7 as a 17, and I'm going to use the 7 and a 1, 7 tens and 1 1. Pop your digits back and try again. This time we're making two different numbers. Have a go yourself. Press pause. Okay, welcome back. How did your second number line go? We were reversing the tens and the ones. So 15 might have also looked like 51. So we've got one lot of 10 and five ones, or five lots of 10 and one ones. And I put my 51 very close to the middle because I know from 0 to 100, 50 is in the middle. Okay, now who pulled out a zero? Because I did. Wasn't quite sure what to do with it. I pulled out an 8 and a 0 to make my 80. But when I switched them around, I found I had a 0, 8. I know where to put my 80, but I'm not sure about this number. This number is telling me there are 0 tens and 8 ones. So really, this is the number 8. So I can place that near my 0 on my number line. Problem solved. All right, let's have a look at my number line. Remember, we've got lots of reversals of numbers. Let's have a look. Here's my numbers less than 50. I've got an 8. I've got a 15. Very close by, I've got a 17. I've got a 39 and a 48. They're all my numbers before 50. They go from smallest to largest. The rest of my numbers look like this. 51, 71, 80, 84, and 93. Another thing I noticed about our number line is I didn't get any doubles. I didn't get any 33s or 66s. Do you know why? I've only got one 6. I can't pull out two 6s. So how will I solve that problem? I've had to think about this myself. I think there's two ways to solve this. The first way is I could pull out a number, read it, write it down, and put it back in. Or I could make more numbers. I can make a second set of 0 to 9, and that will give me my doubles. Good problem solving. Okay, so your task now is to make some more number lines now that you know how to move the tens and the ones to make two numbers and how to create doubles. So good luck, all the best, have some fun with the number lines, and just a little teaser, how might I make more than 100 on my number line? Have a think about that. I'll see you next lesson.